let me show you now the course, what's covered in it, and then I'll give you a look at the materials themselves and some of the things that go into more detail on what people will do in the course. And of course, you might want to go through it yourself. There's 7 modules. They cover customer journey mapping. That's essential to do as part of identifying micro moments. You look at your customer journey, those moments of truth I mentioned, and then the micro moments inside each one of those stages of the journey. Then they create content. You need to create content that matches up with those moments and has the right messaging. And then there's mobile optimization, SEO, engaging on social media. There's the content and the marketing tactics. There's a lot of lessons, action steps, worksheets that I'll show you for actually putting this stuff into practice right away so that your clients, your students can reach their customers in real time when it matters most. And like all of our programs, everything's customizable, ready to deliver and sell the course. This is one of the courses that comes with a full funnel, and I can show you the lead magnet that you can use for building an audience for the course. Learning objectives for the course. These are important from an instructional standpoint of what people will be able to do by the time they're done with the course. So we have pinpoint moments of truth and develop a customer journey map to help you understand your customer's buying experience better. They're going to do a customer journey map and then identify the micro moments inside there in real time so that they can improve their customer's experience and create more targeted, effective marketing. And I'll show you the customer journey map that you would guide them through creating for mapping out everything, those touch points and micro moments. And then they'll be able to develop tailored content to engage and attract customers at the right time so they can turn leads into buyers. They'll learn how to craft mobile-friendly optimized content and engage with customers through social media during those critical micro moments. There's also a module on fostering a business culture that prioritizes customer needs and addresses some common challenges. You go through each of the common challenges to implementing. And there's creating a micro moment marketing plan for all the different steps in there, including picking out the metrics to measure. And there's examples of metrics for each of the types of micro moments. Let's look at each of those in turn, the module by module. And I'll hop over to the slideshow in just a second to show you a little more. First module is on those customer touch points, understanding key decision moments, mapping the customer journey, then looking at the micro moments inside the moments of truth. Now, remember, those moments of truth are things that happen at each stage of the customer journey. You'll see that in the slideshow. So you pinpoint the micro moments in there when customers are likely to act, when they have an immediate need. Those 4 moments, the I want to know, I want to go, I want to do, and I want to buy. Then there's the micro moment messages, so developing content with messages for each of the moments. And each one, remember, is different for every customer's business. There's learning mobile optimization, search engine tactics, and social media strategies for micro moments, overcoming those common challenges that so that micro moment marketing can stay at the center of the business, and creating an actionable marketing plan, tracking progress. And then finally, you finish with some next steps, adapting the strategy to changing trends and staying relevant. Key course materials. Now I will walk through and open up some of these key ones. We've got the course book. That's that full student guide that has all the detail, all the explanation, and something that you will be able to use as a script to go with the slides. There's an action guide and a whole bunch of worksheets in here with some hands-on activities and scenarios and practice and implementation plan. There's the slideshow ready to brand and present or record, so you can use it in multiple ways. And it's broken up by module and lesson. There's the lead magnet and a whole funnel of content to go with that for building your audience, getting leads, and sales page copy that you can use as your starting point for your sales page to convert those leads to new students for your course. And there's a lot more too, and some add-ons that I'll show you. Let's take a quick look at those materials. I'm going to open some of the folders to show you. If we start with the student materials, I can open up the course book. This is the more detailed guide, your student guide that has a ton of different information in it. So if you're delivering this course for the first time, you might want to save this for the second go, because this has all the text, all the explanation that you can use also as a script for the slides. But you can see that there's all this detail. It's 88 pages, but there's graphics and stuff in here too. Each one has details and has the action steps at the end of each. So I'm not going to go into that in too much detail, because we also give you this cheat sheet, which is a high level outline of the course. This is a good document to use, break up into individual PDFs that you can give people to go with each module and each lesson, so they don't have to wade through a long video, or they perhaps prefer to read versus listen. You can give them this high level, and it's a good thing as a reference to go back to. So say you deliver this first module, you present it live, or you record it as a video on using moments of truth to define your customer journey. You would convert this one section to a PDF rather than the whole thing. And then you could put that underneath a video in an online course platform, or you can convert the whole thing to a PDF. And then that becomes your student's little cheat sheet guide, where it's in bullet points. For instance, here we've got lesson 2, identify micro moments in real time. It has just the high level real time monitoring tools, real time customer feedback, different things they can do on the spot, different tools that they can identify and use. Or if I go back to here, identify the micro moments inside the moments of truth, we can see lesson 1, refine your customer journey using micro moments. Everything's condensed down here. They get a quick snapshot and example. So this is an example of an accounting firm and what different moments could be. So this is a really nice way for you to get a quick snapshot of the course and for your students to have a reference point, a reference guide to go back to. Now, one thing I skipped over here was the action guide and worksheets. This is really key to the whole course, this and the slideshow, because this is how people take action and implement, how your students implement what you're teaching them. The slideshow is what you would use to present, to record video. The action guide and some of these worksheets here are matching up with the action steps that you tell them to take. So the action guide is your main part of that, and that matches up with all the modules. And you can see the module 1, there's different places for people to fill in. You would just rebrand this and then give it to people as a PDF so they can print it and write things in. The process of writing things in alone helps with people remembering what they've done. And there are references in here to some of the other worksheets that are provided. One of the things I do when I'm first reviewing one of these courses, and this is a tip for you as the instructor, is I look at the cheat sheet and the action guide and the slideshow separately, but the cheat sheet gives me that quick look of what's covered in the course, and the action guide shows me what they're actually going to do. That gives you a really good feel for what's covered and what's learned and what people do right away. That's how I first review a course and see what's in it. And that's what I recommend you do as well. Then you would look at the slideshow too, because that's what you'd be presenting and you can edit your speaker notes. But this is what I typically do. I look at this action guide and I see, okay, moments of truth. They're going to look at their customer lifecycle marketing model. Then I'd probably go back over to the cheat sheet or the course guide to see the course book to see what that is exactly. And then I see what could you do to improve your weaker areas. They have a separate customer journey map that they get to start filling in. And then you keep going through and seeing what they're doing. So let's look at that customer journey map. This is important because we've given it to you in two forms, a Word document as well as a Canva template. If I open up the customer journey map, you'll see it is four different pages. They have the first part where they're looking at their moments of truth. And if I open up the course book again, I'll show you what that means, what the moments of truth are. Don't worry if you're not familiar with some of these things, because it's all explained in the course book. So here there's an overview. You get this graphic, all these graphics. And this is the customer lifecycle marketing model. In fact, it might be easier for me to show you this on slides instead. So let me open up the slides. And they are in your instructor materials. This is the other key part of your course that you need to make sure you have. Remember, this is for presenting or for recording video, and it's all brandable. So you would just put your own logo in. This is just an image placeholder, and then add any of your styles. The very first part is your introduction to micro moment marketing. And then we have the moments of truth and your customer buying journey. So the customer lifecycle marketing model, which we also cover in detail in a separate course that you can get, is attract, which is develop awareness and explore needs, motivate, which is offer solutions and encourage action. That's where you're actually selling and converting people to customers. And then delight, which is support customers and build loyalty. And engagement is at the center of that. It drives everything. And you'll see there's notes, speaking notes under each slide. Those come from the course book, and you can use those to guide your own presentation and recording. Just make sure you do it in your voice. Give your own language. Don't make it sound like a robot. Don't use an AI voice to read it unless you've gone through and added some of your own language first. So that is the lifecycle marketing model. Then there's the five moments of truth. These are the opportunities for action. They're not the micro moments. Those are smaller, intent-driven, immediate needs. These are other opportunities for action that are part of every customer journey. And they are broken up in five different moments of truth. The 0-1, first moment of truth, second moment of truth, third moment of truth, and the ultimate moment of truth. That's where they become a loyal customer. And these map to that life cycle. So we've got in the attract part, that's the 0 moment of truth. In the motivate part of the cycle, we've got the first moment and the second moment. Second moment is when they actually convert to a customer. And then delight has the third and the ultimate moment of truth. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And there are examples in here as well. I don't want to go through all of these, because the main part of this is then the micro moments that map to it. We have the differences. The moments of truth are the major touch points, and the micro moments are those smaller decision-making instances where customer wants an immediate answer and is usually turning to their smartphone for that. Those are the key differences between the two. And you've probably heard customer journey, customer buying journey, all those different terms in the past. These are part of that. This is going deeper into it. And if I go back to that map again, that's what you're going to have people do in those first couple modules. Look at their moments of truth in their business, in their customer's life cycle. Look at the micro moments in there. And then there's an example of how they match up. You have examples throughout, and when you deliver the course yourself, you can easily customize this to your industry, your customer's industry, by just taking these examples and either using examples you already know that match up with your audience's industry, or this is a really good place for using a tool like ChatGPT or Claude, giving it the example and saying to it, use this example and just keep the same format, but make it for XYZ industry, real estate brokers, whatever it is that you want. That was the customer journey map, and that's one of the key parts of the course. So let me close that up. As I mentioned, you also get that in a Canva template. So if you want to do something fancy here for your students, you can do that. Let me show you. I can show you it. Real quick. You would then use it as a template. All right, let's go back. I showed you a little bit of the slideshow. It continues through the different things that I've talked about, the four different types of micro moments, all those things we talked about that go through for different examples, different types of industries, and you would then adjust those for your industry if you need to. How to recognize the micro moment, different things you can do, like setting up a trigger automation, using tech solutions, real-time monitoring, different types of tools for there. And this isn't a tech program where you're going to be teaching people how to use a specific tool. You should only do that if you know the tool yourself. Otherwise, you can make some recommendations of ones, but you won't be able to actually teach it. Most good tools have tutorials. And if it's something you think is really important that you want to promote, then you should try and use it yourself first. And then you can actually guide your own students through it. But there are different ones listed here in the course and different types of things they can look for to help with those micro moments. Real-time customer feedback, all different things here, different ideas. And that was for real-time monitoring. And then there's the module on creating content for micro moments, different targeted content, different types of things they can create. Different examples here. There's targeted content. So they'll actually create content, but plan out and identify lots of different ideas here for types of content, different examples that you can tailor, tips. And then there's the marketing section on mobile optimization, search engines, and social media tactics, all which is really important for getting found during those micro moments when people are looking to know, go, do, and buy. You're going to have that ingrained in you by the time we're done here. What are the four I want moments, the micro moments? And choosing tactics. You can see there's a few slides for each one of these lessons. So when you present or record these as videos, you would just do one at a time, make a bunch of separate little videos. Minimum 7, but some of these are divided into lessons. So any module where there's separate lessons, like here, module 4 has 3 lessons in it, mobile, optimized for search engines, and social media. You would want to do those as 3 separate little videos. Just take those few slides. And what I like doing is just using a screen recording software so I don't have to break up the presentation and just start it at that particular slide, talk through it, and then stop the recording so that I have just one video. If you like to record things as whole videos, like using PowerPoint, then you would just break up the presentation into smaller presentations, just copy paste. So those are the main things. Lesson 3 was social media. Again, there's examples for each one of the moments. And then there's looking at different challenges and solutions, things like lack of a mobile first approach, different solutions, privacy concerns, not understanding customer behavior, all the different potential obstacles. And then there's actually creating a plan and measuring success. And the very last module will be putting together some next steps. All right, so that's the slideshow. Let me hop back over to the action guide folder. There's the action guide, there's the customer journey map. There are also a couple exercises in here with scenarios for identifying micro moments and examining content to see whether it is appropriate for micro moments. There's also a checklist for content, and there is a planner, the spreadsheet. This goes through each one of the steps that you covered in the course. So you can have your students use this for planning out the different things for each one of their micro moments, or if they prefer to use some other tool like a project management tool, I would do this in our tool, which is Asana, and I would create a section for each one of the steps. So I would have one project for planning out my micro moment marketing plan, and I would have a different section for each one of the steps and plan out the tasks and the responsibility and the dates and all of those different things. But you can do it either way. You would give them the spreadsheet or advise them to use a tool if they prefer doing that. But we like to include that as an option. So I've looked at the main things in the student materials, and we looked at the slideshow a bit. Let me quickly also show you the lead generation material. There are follow-up emails, some blog posts, social media posts, and images, but the main thing here is the lead magnet, which is an assessment. The assessment is, are you ready to capture your customer's micro moments? You might have noticed in a lot of PLR out there, there's just a standard lead magnet that comes with these bigger packages, and it's usually a report. What we do is try and create a lead magnet that makes sense for that particular course. And in this case, we decided that an assessment was the best thing. So your leads can look at where they are now with micro moments, how well they're identifying and capturing those. And then that leads to them wanting to take your course. Assessments are something people love to do. And you just have to frame the scoring so that everyone feels good and they're motivated to take your course. Here, there's an overview set of questions. Then there are questions for each one of the four moments. And they're just a yes, sometimes a no. Like, I want to do you share practical exercises, templates, and how-to content that help customers get the best out of their purchases? It's either yes, sometimes, or no. And they all are assigned a different point value with a total score that they calculate. And then there are different scoring categories based on their performance. Is performing well, on the right track, growth opportunity. All sound fine, but they're framed. The actual descriptions are framed so that it shows where they stand and they're encouraged to do the course. And you want to make sure you put your call to action in there. So that's your main lead magnet that you'd use to build an audience. And as I said, there are other things in there too. Plus, when you're building that audience, you then want to sell your course, and we give you some starting point sales copy that you can use. There are placeholders in the sales copy, some suggestions for titles, placeholders to maybe add your own story. And this is just your starting point. You'd put this into some template that you like for a sales page and then adapt it. And this is another place where you could use something like ChatGPT or Claude and give it this framework for the sales page, ask it how to critique it, ask it what kind of stories you can tell. Just be very careful because it tends to use the same language all the time, but it is very good at making things more concise, giving ideas, critiquing. Can ask it to make it better, give it some of the other information that you've already put together. Testimonials, there's all different places in there. So use that as your sales page starting point. Now that's everything in the main part of the course. That's all the different materials that you'll get in the student, instructor, lead gen, and sales page copy. There's also an add-on workshop that you see after you add the course to your cart. There's a series of suggested add-ons, and I'll show you what that page looks like, and then I'll show you a couple of the add-ons. There are quizzes for the end of each module. You can add those on. There's a mini lab skill practice workshop, and that I'll briefly show you. And then there are some related courses you might want to use to build a series and really scale your income. Quizzes are multiple choice. And the skill practice workshop is slideshow and workbook that you can run as a group or individual activity, and you could even adapt it to a self-study. This is really good as an add-on to the main course because you introduce micro-moment marketing. You could do it as standalone and just introduce the concept and have them practice a bit and then join the main course, or you can add it on to one of the modules where they need some extra practice. Here's the skill workshop. There are the documents in Word, and then there are two things that are also in Canva, the student-facing documents, the slideshow and the work. There's a set of facilitator instructions. So this will guide you through different options, a live group workshop, live individual, and then there's some options for self-study, some preparation steps you'd need to do. And then there's an outline for the actual workshop and guidelines for running it, the skill practice. So there's some timing, there's some notes for speaking notes you can use for introducing micro moments and how they work. Again, it's a nice overview. And you can use this like a script. There's some guidance in there and timing. And then there's the bullet points of what to have people do. If I show you one other thing in here, there are scenarios, fictional scenarios that you guide people through, and then they identify different micro moments and how to leverage those, how to capture those in fictional scenarios. One is a freelance web designer, and there's different customer examples in here. There are four for each one with suggested strategies. The suggested strategies are your answers. So if you run the workshop and then people need some extra guidance, that's where you would give them that extra guidance. The different examples, these fictional scenarios, and they're different types. So the first one was a freelance web designer. The second one was a mobile pet grooming service, so a different type of business. And then another scenario is for a life coach. And those are the three scenarios, three very different ones. Again, you can change these and adapt them to your audience just by putting them into ChatGPT or Claude and saying, okay, follow this format and do a new example for real estate brokers, for local plumbers, but tell it follow the exact same format and include the exact same type of content. And then you'll get these and you can just edit them. It's a very quick, easy thing to do. It just requires some editing, but it's a great way to add some extra scenarios and a really great way to use AI to make things much easier to customize the courses. So those are your facilitator instructions and the scenarios. Your students would see the slideshow that you use in the Canva templates and their own workbook. You get a PDF and it links to the slides. You would just use the template for new design and you have a slideshow that you can follow and present to run the workshop. Nothing else you need to do there. And you get the student workbook. This is something you would send to people as a PDF. You would rebrand this with your own colors and your logo, convert it to a PDF, and then either send it to people or post it somewhere where they can download it, anyone who's going to be in your workshop. So as an example, you might set up a registration page in Zoom for people to sign up for the workshop. And on that registration page, once you would connect to your email, and then in a follow-up email, send them the link to this PDF. Or on a thank you page for the registration, you can often add a link. So it depends on what tools you're using, but try and keep it simple. I would have them sign up via something like Zoom and have the first email that they get with their confirmation have a link to download the PDF. And then it's just a matter of using the slides to present and setting up, having people go into different Zoom rooms. So that's an easy way to do this, or do it as a self-study. Lots of different options, but there are some instructions in with the facilitator instructions. So let's go back now and see what I might have missed. I talked about the Micro Moments Mini Lab group and the different ways you can do that. I did mention those quizzes. That was another thing that you can add on. So if I open that up, this is another way to get more engagement and more interaction to deliver a better learning experience for your students. You don't want to just send them a bunch of videos or an ebook. You want to add more interaction. So things like that skill workshop is one way to add more interaction and do it live. Having these questions at the end of each module. So if you use an online course platform, you can load these in and have all the multiple choice answers. We've marked what's correct. That's something you do in the platform, the course platform. And you can also use these as discussion questions. So a great way to deliver a course that stands out, that's not just one of these really lousy AI-generated ones that people take and learn nothing from, is to add a live element that will always make you stand out and give a better learning experience. And if you're not sure what to do during the live Q&As, use these as your discussion questions, as icebreakers. They can be simple polling questions. Most platforms like a Zoom have that option to add these, or webinar platforms. or you can just say them out loud, use them as general discussion, and then run your live sessions that way, because there's ones for after each one of the modules. So you could have a recorded video and then do a live session each week or every couple of days, depending on how you're delivering it. All right. So those are there if you want to grab those two. And that's everything. So if you're ready to get started with the Micro Moments course, make sure you grab that. Check that out now. Contentsparks.com/micromoments. I hope that was really helpful for you. Talk soon.